This is a podcast to tell you how to assemble a motherboard. Was there ever a time when you turned on your computer and then didn't turn on and you didn't know what to do? Well, keep your hopes up because we have the solution to that. But before anything, we have to know that computers have their own ingredients, just like a cake. A computer is made up of its main components, a CPU and its motherboard, but it's not the unit alone, it's also the motherboard. And with this tutorial, you might actually become your own personal computer technician. Like any other tutorial, steps have to be followed. So first, we have to prepare the materials. Screwdrivers, pliers, screws, CPU, motherboard, optical drives, wiring, hard drive, heatsink, RAM, graphics accelerator, power unit, and there you go, the materials for your computer. And with these, you can actually begin. So let's begin. The first thing you have to do is you have to slide the CPU case. After which, you have to make it down in a sleeping position. Then put the motherboard into the CPU case. After you open the unit door, lay the unit down, properly put the motherboard and then screw it in, then you're done. Next is step 2. We have to be aware the heart of the computer is its CPU. So in the motherboard, attach the CPU inside. All you have to do is push it in, and it's usually automatic. After lifting the CPU and putting the CPU properly and pulling down the lever, then you're done. One of the things we fear is fire. And to prevent this, we need a heatsink. You have to put the heatsink down to the motherboard. And after you put the heatsink on the processor, put the jacks and secure with lever, then you can go on to the next step. An important aspect for computers is its RAM. Or its random access memory. The bigger the RAM, the better. All you have to do is push the RAM in. After pushing the RAM and clipping it in, then you're done. That's how the computer would function. So first, we have to wire it in. After which, we push it inside the unit, and then you're done. After putting the power supply unit in the case and screwing it in properly, then you can go to the next step. That is really important. In the past, AGP was huge. But right now, PCIe is the most common. First, we have to unscrew the back panel of the CPU unit. Then, you can slide the video card in. After removing the back plate, pushing the card in slot, securing the card, and plugging power, then you're done. Next is the hard disk drive or the storage. All you have to do is push it in and wire. After putting it in the bay, securing the drive, connect the power, and connecting the data cable, then you're done. Optical drives are needed to read CDs. Installing them is similar to installing the hard disk drive. So after putting in the bay, securing the drive, and connecting the cables, then you're done. Similar to human beings, the computer can only function when it's all wired up together. So you have to connect the ADX power, the small square power, cabinet cables, and the USB cables, and you're done. After which, just turn on your computer and install. And then you're done. So now you can smile about it and you can say, I can assemble a motherboard.